So magandang araw ka muna. So video na ito, bibigay po natin yung ating updated po na mock draft na power ranking kasi nga po nagbalik na po ang PBA. So niresume na nga po nila. Ito po ang ating Governor's Cup. So we'll provide po natin ito po ang ating power ranking kung saan po you can look at it as our ranking po of the likelihood that this team will win the championship. Kumbaga po kung ito po ay pustahan, ito po yung ranking kung gaano po kalaki ipupusta ko po sa kanila. So yung number 1, basically yung may pinakamalaki po akong ipupusta ngayon na manalo po yung kampeonato, yung number 10, siya po yung may pinakamaliit. So, sa mga hindi pa po nakasubscribe dyan, kabala pa kabindot naman po yung subscription button. Baka magtatanong ka kung bakit po 10 lang yung niraranking po natin. Of course po, ang ginagawa po kasi natin dito kabala is we are ranking those, of course, who wants to win the championship. And we know that there are two teams out there that is certified and in their history, never pong lumapit po na manalo po sila or mapalunan po yung kanila pong championship. And that's of course Terra Firma and Blackwater. Until of course these two teams can start to be serious about competing, hindi po natin muna sila isasali dito po sa ating power ranking. So start na po natin with our number 10, Northport Batang Pier. Basically the third farm team po kabola. So nandito pa rin sila sa ating ranking kasi at the very least sila po lumalapit sila dun sa kampiyonato sa kanilang history. Nevertheless po, for this tournament they are still winless. So there's a big chance now that they will not be able to reach po the playoffs. And I think the management are actually in favor of them not reaching the playoffs. If we consider the fact na halos assured na nga po itong Blackwater Elite in getting po the number 1 pick, malamang hindi po papatalo dyan itong kampo po ng San Miguel Corporation. And of course we are familiar with the connection po of Northport to San Miguel Corporation, kaya naman malamang gugustuhin po ng San Miguel Corporation to at least have 2 of the top 4 picks, knowing na nandiyan din po yung Terra Firma. Number 9 po natin, Rain or Shine Elasto Painters. Ano ang Rain or Shine? We really respect that they are trying to compete, they are continuing to build a franchise, a good team. They are sustaining the team po, they are extending the contracts po of their guys, hindi nila pinapakawalan ka bola. Very, very, very respectful po sa kanilang ginagawa. Pero for this tournament, it is just so hard for me to answer yung tanong na, bakit ako pupunta sa Rain or Shine, diba? So napakahirap po yung sagutin yan in a way, kasi they do not really have that top 15 PBA player, and then malalim man yung team nila, ang problema naman, they also do not have that very elite skill. And then of course yung kanila pong frontline, wala din naman sila masyadong giant. So napakahirap po maniwala o manalik po sa Rain or Shine in winning the championship. Number 8 po natin, Alaska Aces. Currently the number 1 defensive team in this ongoing tournament. Unfortunately, they are also struggling very very hard sa opensa. They currently averaging the second lowest points per game. So mahirap din po magtiwala dito sa Alaska Aces. Hindi pwedeng depensa lang po. Yes, defense wins championship, pero at the very least you need to have an average offense. Unfortunately for Alaska, they do not have that average offense to back up their elite defense. Number 7 natin, Phoenix Fuel Masters. Another franchise po that deserves our respect. Dapat bigyan po natin ng respeto, ng pasasalamat po ang Phoenix, na kahit po iniwan po sila nitong si Chris Banchero, hindi pa rin po sila tumitiklop kabola, knowing that Chris Banchero was actually their best performing player in this tournament. They are still trying to compete, trying very hard to get those W's, and currently they have a very respectable record of 4-2, and they are relying heavily po sa kanilang ball movement. Ano, they are currently averaging the third most assists per game, and that is currently supporting po their identity, which is 3-point shooting, currently averaging the second most 3-pointers made per game. So that's always an excellent combination, the gold ball movement and then elite 3-point shooting. That is still a very very good combination po. Basically that's the modern combination, and they are milking that, and they are currently having a very good record. Tignan lang natin kung magiging mas sustainable pa po ba yung depensa nila moving forward. Number 6 natin, San Miguel Beermen, a team with I think that a top 3 pa rin po na lineup sa tournament po na ito. Unfortunately, yung kasing play po nila ngayon sa court, medyo talagang unsatisfying. And now they will have a new import in Orlando Johnson. He is a legit NBA veteran. Now, that doesn't mean though that we should push them up in these standings or in this ranking, especially with the fact that do they really need a import po that needs the ball that much? Like Orlando Johnson? Yes, Johnson, may magandang argumento that he is the best scorer siguro dito sa tournament po na ito. Pero yun nga, do they really need that? Kasi nga, napaka-loaded na po ng San Miguel Beermen. And what happens now if by having that heavy usage po na import, of course, hindi mo rin naman mamamaximize or mangyayari niyan, mami-minimize mo na yung effect actually ni na CJ Perez, yung na Terrence Romeo, and even Junmar Fajardo. Number 5 natin, TNT Tropang Giga. Unfortunately for them, ano, they lost their last 2 games and kitang-kita natin na maraming problema po ang TNT ngayon. And of course, one of their biggest problem is of course, itong kanila pong magiging schedule in the next few weeks, knowing nga po na they need to sacrifice because they need to be the team with the most players po in the upcoming Gilas tournament. And because of this sacrifice, Kabola, I think mapeperwisyo itong kanila pong pagko-contend dito sa tournament po na ito. Pero yun, wala tayong magagawa, yun na po yung pinili nila. So kung sa mga nagsasabi po talaga na makikinabang dito si Coach Sotres and etc., I doubt, really doubt na at the end of the day he will get anything at all with his decision po to get that Gilas job other than headaches. And yun na nga po yung experience ngayon. Number 4 natin, Barangay Nebro San Miguel, another elite team that is currently struggling. Yes, believe it or not, yung top 3 natin na roster is currently outside the top 3. Kasi ang Ginebra, magkita mo naman po sa play nila sa court, talaga nag-i-struggle po sila. And we know, Ginebra, that their identity po in the last few years po of Coach Tim Cone, where they won a lot of championship, is that defense. Pero currently po, they are bottom 6 in the average po of their opponent's points per game. And that basically indicates defense. So, talagang pinapakita nito na may malaking issue po ngayon sa Ginebra. And that could be the coaching or simply the chemistry of the team na hindi fit. Kasi po, alam nyo ba, in their last game, na itong si Stan Hardinger at saka itong si Aguilar, they only grab 5 rebounds in total. That is not acceptable for that Twin Tower. So, maraming issue na hanggang ngayon hindi pa rin nare-resolve even with the presence po of Justin Brownlee. Number 3 natin, LX Roder Warriors. Simply, I just trust KJ McDaniel. And of course, yung kanila pong sistema kasi, kitang-kita mo naman kung paano po yun. Hindi mahirap i-master. So, madali po nilang na-execute. McDaniels is the guy. Currently, averaging po 31.2 points, 11.5 rebounds, 3.5 assists, and shooting 50% from the field. Number 2 natin, Meralco Bolts. Kabola. Meralco Bolts who just registered 2 huge victories last week. Winning against Ginebra, winning against LX. Basically, they legitimize themselves as a top 2 contender po at this point of the tournament. Ano? They, of course, added po Chris Banchero. Ngayon, ulitin na natin, Banchero is arguably the best Phoenix Fuel Masters po in this tournament and they added him po. Currently, Meralco, they are doing it on defense. They are currently number 2 po on defense and offensively, they are getting a lot from their import, Tony Bishop. Nakahanap na naman sila ng amazing import. Diba kahit hindi po nila pabalik si Durham. So, maganda po ang chance ng Meralco Bolts in this tournament. Number 1 natin, Magnolia Achats. Coach Chito Victorero is really incredible. Wala na akong masabi pa sa pinapakita niya pong coaching performance po sa PBA. In the last few years, defense po ang pinag-uusapan natin in comes to Magnolia because they are always a top 5 defensive team and actually they are still a top 5 defensive team in this tournament. Pero in this one, with Manny Harris as their import, Mike Harris pala, they suddenly turned into a juggernaut on offense, averaging the most points per game in this tournament. Napaka-amazing po ng coaching po ni Coach Chido Victorero. Basically, he's showing us, okay, master ko na yung defense, babakita ko naman po yung greatness ko sa offense. And man, they are my title favorite up to this point. And if tataya kayo ngayon kung sino po mag-champion, they are the best bet for me. Magnolia Hotshots. Kababali sa palagay mo, sino ang mag-champion po? Comment na po sa baba.